So what we're going to try to do is expose a little bit of parallelism, and we're going to do that by first computing A plus B, and perhaps at the same time computing C plus D, and then add the results together. Now, what's that going to look like in terms of our tree structure? So now we've got serial reduce and parallel reduce side by side. Here's serial reduce in the equation. Here's parallel reduce in the equation. Now, what we've done to do parallel reduce is regrouping these operations in a different order. And this exposes more concurrency. We now have the ability to run multiple operations in parallel at the same time. Now you see why associativity was a necessary quality of the reduction operator. We can reassociate operations to expose more concurrency, then we can run concurrent operations in parallel to reduce the time to solution. Let's see how this works with our four-element reduction. Let's compare our serial reduction and our parallel reduction. Both of these have three additions. Both of them have three units of work. But whereas the serial reduction has one, two, three steps to complete, the parallel reduction only has one, two steps to complete. So potentially, we can run this with parallel hardware, and it will complete faster. If we extend this problem to reduce a set of elements of size n, we're very interested in the work and the step complexity as a function of n. So what's the complexity of these four metrics? So three of them are pretty straightforward. The serial implementation here has both order of n, linear work, and linear steps. And the parallel reduction also has linear work, so it's also O of n. But this one's a little bit more complicated to compute. So let's dive in and take a look at this.